Howdy, folks. This is Big Sam. I want to thank all of y'all because we have hit 2,000 subscribers. That is totally insane. That is a number way larger than I thought we would ever hit. And so I want to thank each and every one of you for watching, liking, commenting, and subscribing. It really helps out, and I just really appreciate it. The best thing about this channel is hearing from you guys. I get a lot of great emails about questions and just neat pictures of a rifle that you may own. And I love that, so keep that up, please. Now, in this video, we're staring down a whole lot of rust right here. And you might be wondering why. Well, this is a really interesting rifle. In fact, this is one of the most interesting rifles that I've ever handled personally. And I'm trying to figure out exactly why it exists. So once I have enough research and at least a formal hypothesis conducted, we'll be taking a look at this gun in another video. But as a kind of a sneak peek, we'll be cleaning off some of the rust here, because I think there may be a serial number here on the butt plate that's hiding behind all of this. If I move the camera a little bit, you can kind of see that, yeah, there's a lot of rust over here that we need to get rid of. Now, one other interesting thing about this rifle, this, I will tell you, is an M91 rifle. If we look right here, see this little mark in a circle? This little character is a Russian D. D as in dog, okay? And this is a really interesting symbol because, based on what I know so far, depending on if it's from the World War I era or the World War II era, it means totally different things, okay? And we'll have a separate video to talk about just exactly what this means in both eras. But if you see this mark, this is a really interesting mark, so just know that. Now, how are we going to get all this rust off of here? Well, that's a good question. To try to do that today, I've got my trusty bronze brush here, and we're just going to try to scrape some of this off. And I'm going to get a sheet of paper under here to catch all of the nastiness that's probably going to come off of here. So let's give it a go and see what kind of progress we can make. Now, I'm going to start with the softer tip, and if we need to, we can move to the finer tip. Now, this one's kind of seen better days, but it'll probably still work just fine. All right, it already seems like it's on there pretty good. Now, you can see on our paper, it's kind of hard to see here, but we are getting a little bit of, we're getting some particles. You can't really see that on the camera. It's not really focusing. So we are getting some particles, though. Big old chunk here that's slowly coming off, but I think it's pretty obvious that we're going to need to switch to a coarser side of things. All right. Well, I think this is going to take a while, so we may want to speed this up just a tad. All right, well, we got a lot of it off. Not too bad for a first attempt. And you can see we revealed some of the serial number, and I think some of it may just kind of be gone. But we can see here we've got a 6. We have a 7. We have a 4. And we have a 3. Not sure if there was a number here. There's a number here that may just be gone. It's kind of hard to tell. There are some more things we can do here to try to get some of this off, but again, this was just a first attempt. But not too bad. It's a little more presentable, at least, and we got some of the serial number revealed. Now, This serial number does definitely does not match the rifle, and when we take a look at it, you'll see why. But we can see here this little hammer, if I can zoom in a little bit. Whoa. All right, here we go. See our hammer right here. So we know that this butt plate was produced by the Tula factory before 1928. So that's pretty cool. Gives us a little bit of an idea of what this went on. And again, this is an M91. Now this is cool. This does appear to be original factory font. And I can tell you this is not Finnish. So hopefully we'll get a better idea of what this is in the future. Maybe we'll clean this up a little bit more. You can see, let's take a look at the junk that we actually got rid of. Ooh! That's pretty nasty, actually. And this is why I like to have a sheet of paper under the gun when doing this. I've learned this from experience, because what ends up happening when you have a lot of this surface rust built up and you scrape it off, you get this little fine powder residue, and if you don't have a surface under it where you can just pick it up and move it away, it just gets everywhere. And your wife will probably not be amused by that. Thankfully for me, though, I don't have a woman in my life to tell me no, which is one of the main reasons I'm even able to bring this video to you today. So, hopefully you enjoyed getting to remove some rust from a very old M91 Mosin Nagant butt plate. I'm interested to see how this actually turns out when we're done with it. If we can get any better, or if we can figure out what number, or if there was a number right here. Not really sure, but we'll see. The jury's still out on that one. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I want to thank everyone again for subscribing and liking it. It's so awesome. It really helps out the channel. And I really appreciate it. So please keep it up. Until we meet again, guys, let me know if you have any prayer requests, and I'll see you next time.